ever in San Francisco. I was in Oakland.
You were the did you come in the nation to that?
Yeah, Minister, Honorable Minister Farrakhan and I have an extremely close relationship. He refers to me as one of his sons. So, I spent a particular period of time. Let me explain. Because my particular background was already religious and super strict, right? I didn't find out about other religions by reading about them. I went to their religion. I don't want to learn from Jewish people from outside. I want to be in the synagogue. I don't want to learn about Muslim people from out. I want to be in a mosque. I don't want to hear about the Baptist or the Pentecostal. I want to go to their church and see. And so that was the religious discovery that I was on through that period in my life. About 10 years ago.
Like, 10 years ago?
Yeah, about 10 years.
So you didn't think as a child, because obviously you said the Bears coach, your background, your family is very religious, so obviously you didn't get an opportunity.
I never did a talent show. I was never in any extracurricular activities. I was never in drama. I was never in band camp. I was never a boy scout.
Hey, like, this cool old enough to get for it, you
understand. You understand. So there was no, like, I don't tolerate high school games. I didn't go to high school. I don't know how most of the games they think I play, I'm not even aware of.
But for you to get on stage, and like I said, a lot of comedians that I had up in here, it's like, okay, you know, I told Joe to get girls, I told Joe to, you know, get people laughing at someone else.
Yeah.
But you, it's like, and you say you did comedy one time in Florida.
Yeah.
And you had this other opportunity, like in Oklahoma, that they were going to take you out if you won the talent show. You were going to go on the road with these well-known comedians.
And I did.
But I'm just saying, how in Florida at 13, 14 years of age, you're like, 60, I can do that.
Well, because I knew that there were a lot of other things I could do. Like, when I looked at drug dealers, I thought, I could do that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So right. And who doesn't like that?
Right.
I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to make it. But now that I got to do it on this side, your question was, when did I think I was funny? I never was my biggest fan. To this day, I'm not the biggest fan. I'm a fan of comedy. I like great comedians. Like, I like Chappelle. I like Patrice O'Neal. Like, I like the greats of comedy because I do. Like, I like Ron White. I like Bill Engvall. Like, I know comics. Like, people that did the craft, they raised me. I was touring with Steve Marmel and Richard Denny, a real journey. So my comedy upbringing was standard. I thought you had to work all night, every night, all around the country, and you had to write jokes, and that you were trying to write jokes that other people weren't writing, and that your job was to be funnier. Like, and people that know me will tell you I've been on this. Like, I had a list of all the black comedians that were more famous than me. There was 300 of them on the list, and I had to be able to cross them all out. I could make it to the next level before I felt like I was funny enough to do that. And so I appreciate what competition does for sports and for my particular sport. And comedy is a sport.
What gave you the confidence that you could get on stage?
You remember I was 5 years old on stage.
Okay.
That's not, but I was reiterating God's word at that point. Now, I just have to make sure that the content is good. If the content is good, what part can I not do? I'm a vessel. He's given me these gifts to be able to do certain things, so I just want to utilize them in my craft. That's all.
Do you remember your first set?
Mm-hmm.
Finally.
I'm not trying to offend heavy set women. I'm not trying to upset fellow comedians. I'm not trying to do any of that. And I'm not trying to do none of that and still eviscerate you, because I'm smart enough to know that I need to say that you have gnarled fingers, because I know your limited education means you don't know what the word means. So you can't possibly respond to it. You're not sure.
Thank you.
I wish you a good evening. Thank you. A good evening to you.
Teammate, bro, you got a this is the first duos game I've ever played. What? It worked? Nah, let me get that. Oh, wow. Lucky tough. Hey, watch the boy be tough though. Hold on. Let's get right, bro.
Stop.
blood bags over there.
Hey, good shit. We getting third party too.
Hold up, bro. I cannot hear you. Hold up. Talk. I'm not gonna lie. I couldn't hear you for a second. What? Bro, he shot me through the wall.
So I'm gonna listen to some of the J-Lo stuff. Now, I've never met her because she didn't allow the opportunity. But basically, Jennifer Lopez filmed Jersey Girl with Ben Affleck and Liv Tyler at a diner, like, down the street from the Grams house. So in Berlin, New Jersey, that's like, it was like such a big thing. And my aunt was a huge Ben Affleck. I love Ben Affleck. So one day after school, when they were filming, she took us to stand outside the diner and wait for him to come out. So like, we took a chance, but I was like, and which is why I don't really, I'm not one to jump on the bandwagon to bash them. But this has always left a sour taste in my mouth for Jennifer Lopez. So